More environmentally friendly vehicles, those that emit less emissions and aren't dependent to run on fossil fuels, is a huge trend. But this idea of sustainable living, sustainable driving, isn't a new one. Almost 100 years ago, Buckminster Fuller was looking into the future when it came to nature, to our environment, and he saw what was coming.
One of the earliest people to use that term, that we need to be on a sustainable path. Buckminster Fuller began talking about these topics back in the 20s and just analyzing it from a data standpoint and saying if we continue on the current trajectory, we're going to be in trouble.
Fuller was an architect, an inventor, a futurist.
Buckminster Fuller's entire life and his legacy was about finding out what one human individual could do to affect the greater good.
He's most known as the guy behind the Geodesic Dome.
He provided it as a solution because it uses the least amount of construction materials to enclose a volume of space architecturally.
There's a few of them in our region, and the Center for Spirituality and Sustainability is a dome designed by him on the campus of Southern Illinois University-Edwardsville.
Buckminster Fuller designed this geodesic dome for the Southern Illinois University campus in 1971. So we're celebrating and honoring his legacy here on this building's 50th anniversary and trying to draw as many different connections across the artifacts and inventions that he designed, including the car.
Before Fuller devoted himself to improving human shelter, he worked to improve the efficiency of the automobile. This is the Dymaxion Car. The teardrop shape created less wind resistance. It had three wheels, rear wheel steering, and was about 20 feet long. Its body was aluminum. Fuller designed it to have maximum output with minimum material input. This was literally a car for the future. It had wheels for ground travel, and Fuller anticipated that future yet developed technology would allow the Dymaxion to fly. Three were built between 1933 and 34. The only surviving prototype of this revolutionary car lives at the National Automobile Museum in Reno, Nevada.
The version of the Dymaxion car that we have visiting the Fuller Dome today is the 1933 prototype version that Jeff Lane of Lane Motor Museum in Nashville, Tennessee rebuilt. So he fabricated the parts and made it a perfect replica of the 1933 version of the Dymaxion car.
It's really fun. I've been a fan of Buckminster Fuller for a long time. Just his work is inspirational.
The Nunez-Schoen family came out to see the Dymaxion in person, and their son, Artie, was very impressed.
It feels like an airplane is like taking off, kind of. And also when it honks, it makes super loud.
Well, was it awesome?
Yes, very.
Okay, going for my ride in the Dymaxion. Let's see how we get in. We get in. Oh,
it's a big step up.
This is very.
And it's not a big door.
This is.
Once you're in, it's not bad, right?
This is got some nice leg room.
It does.
I like this. We're ready.
All right, we're off.
Okay. How does it run?
I mean, it runs good. It drives because of the rear steering. It drives kind of weird, kind of like a forklift, right? So, you know, you gotta be careful because the back end swings out.
Just like its creator, the Dymaxion was ahead of its time. It debuted at the 1933 World's Fair in Chicago, but it was hit by another car and the driver was killed. Investors weren't interested in the car of the future after that.
If you were designing a car for an economic reason, to have a profitable business, you would do focus groups and find out what it is people wanted and mm-hmm. give that to them. You know, that wasn't his motivation at all for any of his inventions. He wanted them to be artifacts that would change the trajectory of human behavior towards a sustainable future.
Are you like the Beatles driving around in this car? Is this like fans everywhere?
People see this car, right? They're like, even I think she probably knows what it is.
Well, Artie was right. It was loud and very awesome. For Living St. Louis, I'm Anne-Marie Berger.